Hello viewers, hello listeners, hello everyone. Thank you once again for joining me on DMAPS TV. Please don't forget to subscribe if you are coming for the first time. If you're regular, just do the usual. Please like and comment and also share our video so that others may see what we do. What we do is we give you current affairs in real time. So yes, we've got this update from the strategic tracker leadership. Of course, yes, it is from one of the diplomats in SADC, and she said that the SADC has given ZANU-PF a list of options to consider before it is sanctioned and summoned by regional entities. Of course, yes, ladies and gentlemen, this issue of SADC against the state of Zimbabwe, against the government of Zimbabwe, is continuing, and it seems as if SADC is still seized with resolving the matter of the Zimbabwean elections. Yes, this has given hope to the people of Zimbabwe whom were losing hope according to the passage of time, but they have been reminded that in 2008 the GNU the talks began only about 2 to 3 months after the election, and some of the government ministers actually come into effect in 2009. So this is what is happening. The SADC has given ZANU-PF 3 options. They drafted to them and sent them to send them 3 options to consider. They have also sent the same options to Nelson Chamisa. They have also sent these options even to the civic society organizations and all interested parties in this issue, as they are trying to map a way forward, as they are trying to resolve the Zimbabwean crisis caused by the disputed election of 23 to 24 August 2023. So the first option that SADC gave ZANU-PF to consider is a new election that is run by either SADC or the United Nations or both. Of course, yes, ladies and gentlemen, we saw that SADC has said that it does not supervise elections in its member countries, but what we are saying is that they expect a body that is created for the sole purpose of managing this election, and this body will be constituted with members from the SADC, members from the United Nations, and also local bodies, including the civil society organizations. And the second option that the SADC gave to ZANU-PF was a transitional authority that is constitution of ZANU, CCC, civil society, and churches to reform the electoral laws and subsequently run elections. Of course, yes, so that advocate Nelson Chamisa also mentioned about the transitional authority in his recent rally. So it is said that the SADC is saying Zimbabwe will need a transitional authority that will be hell bent on improving the electoral laws of the country, on reforming the electoral laws. Of course, yes, we have witnessed that there hasn't been much in reforming electoral laws in Zimbabwe ever since the opposition came into being, but now the SADC is saying that they need a transitional authority that will include the government, the opposition, and the civil society organizations, as well as churches, to spearhead the reform process of electoral laws in the country. Then the third option is going to be a GNU that is consisting of parties in parliament to run until the next election and fixing laws in the process. So this is the third option, which is a government of national unity. Yes, we saw how a government of national unity came into being in 2008 and how it resolved things, at least for the people of Zimbabwe. Things were good. Even the exchange rate was no longer fluctuating, even the inflation rate was tamed, even everything, even the general standards of living for the civil servants, for the private sector workers, everything seemed to behave normalized during the government of national unity era of 2008 to 2013. So that's another option that was given to the ZANU-PF party. Then, so after all these options, they were given a sort of like an ultimatum to say, if you do not implement any one of these, or at least consider any one of these, you will face drastic consequences. Of course, this is said to involve the sanctioning and summoning by regional entities. Of course, yes, we know Zimbabwe is on sanctions, the Zedera sanctions, but now we are saying that it is at risk of also being sanctioned by regional entities. Yes, the regional bodies that include SADC, that include African Union and the likes, and also it is at risk of failing to mend their relationship with all these regional neighbors, of all these continental neighbors and the like. So SADC has warned Zanu PF of the consequences of failing to adhere to its options, at least one option which will be viable to them. And a lot of people are calling for new elections. Of course, when you are into things like politics, you always follow what your leader is saying. A lot of Zimbabweans who commented on the issue said, we don't want any GNU, we don't want any transitional authority, but what we want actually are new elections that are run by either the SADC, the United Nations, or both of these entities. So it seems that this is the most viable option that the people of Zimbabwe want. Of course, it is being moved. This motion is being moved by the CCC. They've said that they want fresh elections in Zimbabwe that are far away from the Zimbabwe Electoral Commission. We know how the Zimbabwe Electoral Commission has even lost funding due to how it ran the past elections. Yes, we saw that UN withdrew funding from the Zimbabwe elections. So it is said that the UN is saying, we would rather fund the new player that will come into being to manage Zimbabwean elections. And they have also promised and said that we are not going to sweep this Zimbabwe election matter under the carpet, because what this just does, it will make things even harder for the people of Zimbabwe. So they assist with the matter, and they are going to correct the matter according to the correspondences that are coming. And people are losing hope due to how the time has passed. But SADC continues to say that, no, it takes time, but it shall be well for the people of Zimbabwe once all these things have come in place. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, it is a big thing that is about to happen, so it will take time, but be encouraged. Everything is happening behind the scene. A lot of things are happening behind the scene. That is why Nelson Chamisa, the advocate, remains hopeful that it shall be well with the people of Zimbabwe. Anokone kanemfaro ndinwenyu Honorable Madiva.